It's Ted Nugent news time, so you know it's going to be something crazy and probably offensive. Recently, he was in San Antonio talking about a feral pig hunt that he went on. If you're not from Texas, you might not know about this, but basically there's huge herds of feral pigs that need to be culled at some point. So he was talking about that, and he went off into very offensive territory. Here's the quote. He says, "Lots of places have a hog problem. In Texas, the hogs have a Ted problem." He described the giddy joy of shooting from the open copter with an M4 machine gun. "And 4 hours later, I had 450 dead hogs." Then he added as an afterthought that produced ample laughs, "And now if they would just take me to South Central, okay, I kid."
See,
he's joking, he kid.
He's joking about slaughtering minorities like hogs.
Yeah, shooting blacks and Latinos from a helicopter, I kid.
And they laughed. He did actually get a good reaction to that. It wasn't like the Zimmerman knock-knock joke.
You know, it's a funny thing because If he had said it about like Libya or Middle Eastern country, whatever, like as offensive as it might have been, I feel like I would have let it go more because he's joking about a war. I mean, you could just, a thinnest excuse for context. Do you see what I'm saying? But here there's no context, there's no excuse, there's no nothing. It goes to state of mind. Who thinks like naturally like, oh man, if I could shoot blacks from a helicopter, that would be awesome. Yeah. Like, why is that funny to anybody? Why does that come to anybody's mind? To me, it's the most obvious thing in the world. I mean, there's no excuse. He's absolutely a feral racist.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, there was nothing, like, contextually, nothing about South Central going on. That was already primed in his mind to talk about. This is something he's thought about in the past.
You know, my point will be helped if you go first.
I don't really have much of a point other than that I try not to pay attention to Ted Nugent because he says this stuff all the time. I mean, he's crazy. Sorry, the guy's crazy. You know, he says racist stuff. Maybe the context was that, you know, because it's in California, it's full of a lot of liberals, and that's why we should shoot him up.
Perhaps. No, then you would have gone to San Francisco or Massachusetts. That would have given it context.
I was actually trying to help him out.
I would have accepted that. If he had said San Francisco, Massachusetts, it's still a vile thing to say, but I would say he's joking about shooting liberals. But there's nothing like, joking about killing blacks is not a thing. It's not a joke.
I got it.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Like, see, what, you didn't come through for me.
I'm so sorry. I disappointed you.
Well, because I think when I'm on a panel with four people and everybody agrees, I think that's the number. Like, I can handle three, but I get to four, and then I start looking for ways to defend Ted Nugent, one of the three worst people in the world, right? Mm-hmm. But, like, it starts as a joke. Like, I got it. We know Ted Nugent's a racist. I don't have any problem saying that. That's really clear. But since it started as a joke, and in fact, actually has a funny line in it, like that you laughed at, and I laughed at too.
Ted problem.
In Texas, the hogs have a Ted problem. Like, that's funny.
Okay.
So he's already in the joking world, and then he ends it with, like, somewhere that is gang associated, and that he could rectify the problem of killing the bad guys. Like, so it doesn't strike, this does not, because he was already kind of joking, strikes me as the 73rd worst thing Ted Nugent has said.
Yeah, I don't agree, but I know where you're coming from, obviously. I get what you're saying. But let me flip it. And this goes to Alona's point and why we decided to cover the story in the first place. Because Ted Nugent gets invited to every conservative convention. He gets invited on Fox News all the time. He's seen as a legitimate person within the right wing.
He's playing a show here in the Southland, here somewhere in Southern California, like, you know, at a casino. And, you know, and I just heard the ad, and I'm like, God, it's crazy. Maybe I was listening to a game somewhere else, so it might have been, like, in Texas. But, I mean, who runs an ad for Ted Nugent?
So if there was the equivalent of someone who was really respected in the liberal community, went to all the conventions, was on MSNBC as a star guest all the time, et cetera, and joked about, like, wouldn't it be go to, let's say a black guy who said, wouldn't it be great to go to Kansas and shoot white people from helicopters? I kid.
Right.
Over. End of career.
Yeah.
End of career over, except the way that one reason why Ted Nugent will get out of this one is that he just said South Central and he didn't say kill black. He didn't use.
South Central is not big.
I think it's implied.
No, I know, right? But I mean, it's a big difference. Like, if that guy says.
But if he said, oh, I mean, go to Kansas, and he's a black guy and he's talking about shooting things, and I go to Kansas and shoot some folks.
Yeah, it's just how things work.
It's pretty clear.
He's going to get out of it because South Central's rep.
But no, your point is very important because first I was sitting here thinking to myself, is Ted Nugent even influential? Does anyone care what he says? But you're right. He's totally embraced by the right-wing community, and so that is problematic.
And really fast. So also, if you've been watching the show recently, you might remember that after a League of Legends online video game, a kid said, jokingly on Facebook, I'm going to kill people and eat their still beating hearts. LOL JK. He was in prison for a couple of months in solitary confinement. He said JK at the end of it, but he's still talking about killing people. Why isn't he in prison right now?
His name is Justin Carter. He was in prison for 5 months. Only got out because a rich benefactor put up the $500,000 bail because he was so outraged by the story.
So outrageous.
Right. And he, solitary confinement, stripped down naked,
beaten,
unconscious, et cetera, inside the jail. JK, just kidding. Now, he can joke around, but Ted Nugent can joke around about killing black people and Latinos in South Central, and he goes on Fox News, he's a celebrity, gets paid to go to conventions. And remember, like, come on, I gotta say it every time, right? You remember who Ted Nugent is. This is the guy who is such, he's like literally the biggest coward in the country. In Vietnam, he literally crapped himself. This is a literal story from Ted Nugent. Ted Nugent said the story, right? He crapped himself for a week so that when he went to the draft board or whatever that is that they decide whether you're going to go in or not, they said, oh, he's crazy. This guy's lost his mind. He's living in his own feces. And so he got out of Vietnam by doing that. I mean, he was so scared, he shit himself instead of getting into real combat. And look at the thing here. Oh, I'm such a man, I'm in a helicopter, I'm shooting unarmed pigs, and he gets
some
such
of them
a-
armed.
Yeah, okay. Like, oh, he's not even on the ground. He's not even on the ground. He's like, oh my God, I'm scared of the pigs. I shoot them from here. Oh no, I cramp myself. Okay, and this guy is like the star of the right wing.